In this video tutorial, I'm going to teach you all about how to use curves in your photo editing workflow. I'm using Luminar AI to demonstrate, but if you're using Photoshop or Lightroom, you'll find a curves tool there as well, and you can follow along. So whatever software you're using, these will be some great tips to help you. I'm Darlene with Digital Photo Mentor. I help beginning and intermediate photographers improve their work right from capture in camera all the way through to the photo editing process and the final image. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Let's dig in and learn about curves. To get started, I've created a grayscale image from black to white with different steps of gray tonality in between to demonstrate. So we're going to look at this in curves, and then we'll see how it applies to a few different images. So the principle behind curves is that you can use the curve, or the tone curve as it's called, to adjust the contrast in your image, but you can get really specific. So there's several different ways inside of Luminar AI to adjust contrast. I'll show you a few, and then I'll show you why curves gives you more flexibility and is a little bit more advanced editing tool. So the first one is in the light panel, which is where you'll find most of these things I'm going to demonstrate. That's the smart contrast. So let's drag that one all the way up to 100. So you can see what happens. It's kind of just stretching the tones out. The ones closer to white are getting brighter, and the ones closer to black are getting darker. If we go the other way, you'll see that it's the opposite. The light tones closest to white are being darkened, and the tones or shadows closest to black are being lightened. So smart contrast is a great tool inside of Luminar AI. Next, we can adjust contrast with the highlights and the shadows. So if you take the highlights up, they get brighter, and we take the shadows down, they get darker. And you can see what's happening again in this area and in this area. If we do the opposite, we're going to brighten the shadows and darken the highlights, including the background, which is white. So now you have more of an image that is a lot flatter without pure black or white. Okay, so these are some of the tools that you can use to adjust your contrast. You can also use the white slider and the black slider. And I'm going to hit the J key just to show you what's clipping in this image. Okay, so anything that is red is pure white with no detail. So as expected, the background and the first square. Anything that is highlighted with blue is black with no detail. Again, as expected, the black square. So let me drag the white slider up. And as I do, it doesn't really affect things too much in this particular image. Things closest to white got a little bit brighter. If I go the opposite direction, you start to see the shadows creeping into more of the clipping areas. So what it's controlling is the very ends of the histogram. So black on the left, white on the right. Just undo that. Now let's take a look at how you can do all of those same things using the curves tool. When you look at the curves tool here, it's actually a straight line before you adjust it. So it goes from the bottom left, which is pure black, up to the top right corner, which is pure white. You'll also notice that I've got the histogram on here, and you can see the same histogram in the background of the curves tool. Okay, so because there's just different levels of gray here, you'll see various different spikes in the histogram. So what I'm going to do is take this left one and slide it in to the right a little bit. And you'll notice that as I do that, I'm starting to darken all of those shadow tones over here until they're pure black. Okay, so remember my J key shows clippings. Then I'm going to do the same with the whites and go to the right, to the left, pardon me, until I just have white and black. Let's go a little bit further and gray. Right. So as I come in on the left or left part of the graph, I get darker. Come in on the right side of the graph, it gets brighter. Okay. So those are the basic principles and how it works similar to the blacks and the white sliders. Okay, it just goes a lot farther. But you also have all this range in the middle, okay? The slider down the bottom here is actually mid-tones, okay? So I can just drag it up or down. But look what happens to the curve as I do that, okay? So you can use this slider here, or you can just grab the middle line and drag it up or down. So down darkens and up lightens. Now let's say I want to add more contrast. So you want to make what's called an S curve in that case. So you want to drag the shadows down and the highlights up. And I'm going to go a little more extreme just so you can see it. Now look at the shape of the line on top of the curve here. It's an S, shape of an S. And when we do a before and after, you can see that it has indeed increased the contrast. Now where things start to get really interesting is that you actually have different colors in the curves as well. So I'm going to undo this. Every color image is made up of three different layers, red, green, and blue. And when you are working with the curves tool, you have each of them to work with separately. So the same principles apply, but now I'm only working on red. So if I raise the line, it goes to increase the red. If I lower the line, it's going to decrease red or give me the opposite color, which is cyan. Okay. If I do the same with green, what do you expect if I raise it? It's going to give me more green. If I lower it, it's going to give me the opposite, which is magenta, okay, or a pink tone. Blue, if you raise, you get blue. Opposite of blue. Now keep in mind, this is on the color wheel, and I'll show you the color wheel. So this is literally just color theory. Yellow, okay, so these are what's called complementary colors, and they come into play here on the curve as well. So let's say I want to get a little more creative. I want to have blue highlights, but I want to have either neutral or yellow shadows. Now I've created what's called a split tone. And you can get really creative with these types of things inside of curves because you can add as many points as you want. And you can start doing some crazy stuff, right? Now look at, I've got colors all over the place, right? So this type of thing starts to get into like solarization and really bizarre colors, right? But just know that when you play around with the curves, these kinds of things are possible. You can also incorporate, let's say, a little bit of blue into the image. And then let's say I want to have some red in my shadows. So I'm going to go up and keep the highlights either neutral or towards cyan. And now we're really starting to create something a little bit different and creative. So these are tools that allow you to use it in an element where you want to add style to an image, or if you just want to correct an image that has a little bit of a blue tint to the shadows, you can use this as well. Let's take a look at an actual image. This image of my model, I'm just going to do a quick white balance correct using the targeted tool and the gray card. Maybe she's a little bit blue. And I'm just going to increase her exposure a little bit. But what I want to do now is, using the curve, adjusting the contrast, because I want to add a little bit more contrast. In an image like this, when I'm looking at the histogram in the background here, it looks pretty good. It looks pretty even. Nothing's going off either side. So I'm just going to pinch the black in a little bit so it kind of touches the edge of where the information is. If you want to make sure you're not clipping anything, turn on that with the J key, the clipping warning. Now I noticed that my highlights are a little blown out, so I could use this tool to bring them down, but I'm actually going to use it to increase the contrast just a tiny bit. And then I'll use the highlight slider over here to bring it down. Now notice that when I use the highlight slider, you see how the graph behind the curve is also being affected. So you can see that all of these tools work together to create contrast. So really quickly, I've just added a bit of contrast to her using that curve layer. Now she looks a little bit green to me, so I could adjust the tint up here because I've gone a little too far. Or I could say, okay, she looks a little bit green. I just need to pull this down a little bit over here and adjust the highlights. Okay. Now I'm starting to create something that's a little bit funky in terms of a cross-processed look. It's really easy to go too far with curves, so be careful when you're using curves for this type of color correction that you don't take it too extreme. Here's another example. And all I've done so far is just change the camera profile to give it a little bit more color. And I'm going to play with the curves here. This time, you'll notice that there's a little bit of a gap from the end of where the information is and the end of the graph. So what I'm going to do is take this white point here and just push it over. And you'll notice they start to come meet each other until it's touching sort of the edge there. And I could do it with this slider as well, right? They do sort of the same thing. Now I've got a lot more white in the image. If I keep going, you'll start to see the whites clipping up in here in the building and the tower. So I'm gonna bring it back a little bit so I don't have that clipping. And let's make a little more black. I find that when I increase the blacks, it gives the image more punch and it also saturates the colors. So let's take a look at a before and after. Okay, so I've just cleaned up the color and given it a little bit of punch. Now, if I want to continue, I can make it more of an S curve like I did on the other one. And now you can see that the contrast is really starting to increase. If you want to go the other way, you just have to do an inverted S. So you're going to lower the highlights here and increase the shadows a little bit. Now you can see that the image is a bit flatter. If you've never used the curves tool before, what I suggest is building yourself a grayscale image or find something like this on the internet. Just find a color wheel. This is what I was talking about earlier with the opposite colors, red and cyan and so on. And play around with the curves on here just until you learn and get an idea of what they're doing. So increasing the contrast and doing things like shifting the color. Play around with the curves using your color wheel image and learn how the tool works, and then go and apply it on some of your images. If you want to learn more about other ways of adjusting contrast using Luminar AI, watch this video now. Please click the thumbs up button now and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any new tutorials. Be well and keep taking pictures.